Are you using MVVM in your SwiftUI apps? Well, if you do, I'm here to tell you that there's a better way, and that is the IVO design pattern. Now, if you do want to know what IVO means, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and open up Xcode and let's dive in. So let's talk about design patterns in SwiftUI. As you already know, if you have taken a look at SwiftUI tutorials, you will know that MVVM is the chosen design pattern for SwiftUI by Apple. Now, MVVM has been around for more than SwiftUI, so it's MVVM, so model, view, view model. And it's kind of okay, like it's not okay, it's the kind of the best practice for SwiftUI, but I would challenge that this is kind of outdated. We need a different SwiftUI design pattern, an updated one, which is kind of like this MVVM, but it's much simpler and much SwiftUI like. So I will talk about this today with a hands-on example. By the way, if you do like my teaching style, take a look at rebeloper.com/mentoring, where I will be joining you on a 60-minute Zoom call. Whenever you want to learn SwiftUI, or maybe just do want to fix your bug in your code, I am available. Again, it's rebeloper.com/mentoring. So let's just jump right into it, and let me just show you this new design pattern that I came up with, and it's called IVO, identifiable, view, and observed. It's much more SwiftUI like than MVVM, model, view, view model. Okay, so what am I talking about here? So let me just bring up this nice PNG IVO, and you can find this, by the way, down in the link of the resources, where you will find all the resources for my YouTube channel. And just scroll down to this appropriate date, and you can download all of these resources. So it's IVO, identifiable, view, and observed. And before I jump into the hands-on example, let me just talk a little bit about it. So here, the main focus is the view. And of course, we have this identifiable, which actually is kind of the model of the MVVM design pattern. So this identifiable is tied to the view and the view only. So that's just it. We do need identifiable models in our views, because for example, if we are using them in a for each view, they need to be identifiable, of course. So identifiable, it's really simple to know, because that's how models work in SwiftUI. Now, view, you already know about the view. Everything is a view in SwiftUI, so I won't talk much about that. Let's talk about this curious part here, the last part, and that is observed. Now, think of the observed as the view model in MVVM, but it's much more SwiftUI like. Now, observed is actually an observable object, which interacts with the view. So for example, if you do have a published variable on the observed, then the view will actually update itself automatically when the published variable is updated. So that's why we have this kind of error. So observed will update the view. And what is this error at the bottom or on the left side of the view? Well, actually, from the view, we should navigate away, like not navigate, we should just tuck away everything that is logic-based or not view-based into the observed. So for example, if you do want to fetch from an APR or something like that, make sure that we are doing that inside the observed. For example, in our code, we are on this example code that I'm going to show, we are going to fetch the profile. So we are going to do that part on the observed. So that's IVO in a nutshell, identifiable, view, observed. So let's take a look at a hands-on example. And what I did here beforehand is just started a brand new Xcode SwiftUI project. I haven't touched anything here. It's just vanilla template code from Xcode. Now, let's start off with creating our identifiable. So let's create a profile, which we will later on fetch. So for that, let's create a new file right over here, and let's just select Swift file. Let's create, click on next and name it profile. There we go. And this will be a simple profile. Let's just import SwiftUI first, because we are going to need identifiable, of course, here. And let's create our struct really fast. So here's our struct, copying out the name profile. And I omitted that. Here we go. So this needs to be identifiable. So let's add it right over there. And now we will have an error, because type profile does not conform to identifiable. And that's really easy to fix. Now you could use some of, all we have to do is just add an ID here. Well, you could use the ID that you got from your server, but I highly recommend just creating a UUID string here. So that would be like var ID. So make sure that this is ID, spelled like this, ID. And then just give it a default value, UUID. And UUID string. So that would be a uniquely created string. And let's just add some more, because now identifiable is taken care of, but let's build out our profile model a little bit more. So let's just add the creation date. So created at, created, not created, but created at. And this would be of type date. And let's also have a new variable name of type string, because yeah, this is a profile and we do want to present that on the view. Okay, and this is kind of it. Now we have a struct with a predefined initializer, because we added these properties, and that should be it. But I would reckon that you should create a new initializer for this, another initializer, in fact, which you will see that we are going to use in the observed when we are going to create the published variables. So let's create an initializer here, and let's add in here. Of course, the ID is already initialized, so we don't need that. Let's add created at. Now, what is the purpose of this initializer? Well, for example, if the name will not exist, for example, on your database, but you do have it right over here, then you must give it a kind of a default value. So this is what this initializer will do. So let's start off with the created at the date. Let's make it an optional and set it to nil by default. Now, why is that? Well, because now we are going to go self created at and give it created at the optional date. Now, this, if this doesn't exist, let's give it a default value of our current date, just like that. Okay, let's do the same for our name. So I just copy that out, add the comment here, new line, optional string equals nil, and then let's give it a default value. Like, let's give it to the property actually first. So name equals name, and then give it a default value of an empty string. And that's it. Now, you will see why this is so important when we are initializing published variables in just a second. But that's our identifiable. You already know everything you need to know about identifiable. So this is really, really simple. By the way, one of the purposes of IVO design pattern is to make this really, really simple and reusable. So every SwiftUI developer that touches your code will instantly know what's going on. Okay, so next up, let's create kind of the glue between the content view and our profile, and that is the observed. So let's just create a new file here, and I will name this, so new file, and that will be, again, a Swift file. Let's click on next, and that is content view plus observed. Okay, and you will see in just a second why I named it like so. So import, let's just import Swift UI. And now let's have an extension of our content view. Why do we have an extension, actually, you ask? Well, why don't we create our view model, our observed, outside of our content view? Well, this is because, it's separation of concern, but we don't want this view model, this observed, to be hanging around there to everybody's access, like every other view's access, so they can use it do whatever they like. We are simply going to tuck this away inside the content view where actually it should be. It shouldn't be accessible. Well, if you do want to make it accessible, just pass it along. So here is our content view, and let's create our class, because this observed is actually an observable object. So observed, there we go. Every observed will be named observed because it's tucked away nicely in that particular view, so we won't have these name conflicts. Okay, and that will be an observable object. Okay, and yeah, basically that's it. We are now have our observed. And what do you want to add on an observable object? Of course, you do want to observe something, and that is our profile. So let's create a published variable, and that is profile equals profile. And now if you hit open parentheses, you will see two options. Well, if you didn't add the initializer, you will see only one, this created add with the name. This is the automatically generated struct initializer. But here we just use this one, so we may use the initial values. Really, really nice. Now you know how powerful that initializer is. By the way, if you don't know what these published variables are or all of that stuff, go ahead and check out the data flow video on my YouTube channel. Okay, so it's called binding in SwiftUI. Okay, so that's that. We have our observed. Now we want to link it to our content view, and that will be kind of the final part of this step. As you can see, it's really straightforward and simple. And because this will be the source of truth for our observed content views observed, we are going to initialize it as a state object. So let's just go at state object var, and the private, let's just have it private right over here. That's why it should be so, private var, because it shouldn't be accessible when we are creating our content view. Okay, so observed, and that will be just observed. That's observed. As you can see, we can use auto completion because it recognizes that observed is of an extension of content view. And basically that's it. Now, if we do want to access that published variable, then we can do so right over here, like observed.profile.name. And now you can understand why I named this observed, because it's much, much readable. So observed.profile.name. So give me the observed profile's name. Really, really nice. Okay, so that's how we kind of interact from the observed to the view. But what about the other way around, when the view needs to do some work under the hood? So, well, it's not going to do it under the view will do its work, but we are going to do the work on the observed. So let's just create a new function here. So func fetch profile. Okay, there we go. And I'm also going to create this fetch profile first in the observed, and then I'm going to hook it up. So let's just go back to our observed right over here, and let's create a new function, a fetch profile. And what do I want to add in here? Well, I want a completion handler, and that will complete with an error, but that will be an optional error. So we might fail here, and if we do, we want to propagate that error all the way up. Oh, by the way, I just forgot here the caret. Okay, that's nice. So we want to propagate the error all the way up to the view, so we may show it, if that's appropriate, to our users on the view. So we may show it, for example, inside an alert. Okay, so that's why on the observed, I'm always creating these functions with a completion of optional error and nothing else. Not the profile. I'm not moving the profile all the way up to the view, because the profile is taken care by the published variable. Great. So let's just have here some sort of a mock fetch. And yeah, let's just create here a profile. So let profile equals profile. And let's just use created at. And because this is optional, I can just omit created date and it will use the default value, so the current date. And then let's just have here Alex. Okay, so that's our profile. And let's just mimic a 2 second or 1 second delay. And dispatch queue, I'm going to use that one, main.async after the deadline. And the deadline will be dot now. And plus 1 second, and then we are going to execute self.profile. Now this profile is called with self because we are inside the completion handler, and this profile actually is the published variable profile. Profile equals now the profile that I have just created with the name Alex. So that's how we are just going to give that published variable its value. And now all we have to do is initiate this fetch profile on the content view. Let's just go back and we just go observed dot fetch profile. We might get back an error, so let's take care of that. If let error equals error, then we are just going to print out that error. Localized description. Yeah, you should definitely show an alert here, but for now, this tutorial's sake, this is more than enough. And basically, that's it. That's all we have to do. Well, yeah, actually, we do want to call the fetch profile. That's not all you have to do. You want to call this fetch profile when this view appears. So I'm just going to remove padding and add it on appear with the perform and fetch profile. And that's it. That's everything that you need to know for this IVO design pattern. So let's check it out. Let's just build and run. And hopefully you kind of understand it. It's similar to MVVM, but it's much more clearer. You know, IVO, identifiable, view, and observed. And by the way, observed, it's much more readable, identifiable. It's much more intuitive because you do know then that your models need to be identifiable. And the view, of course, is the view. And there it is. After 1 second of appearing of this view, of that text actually, Alex will be added to the profile, which is automatically updated on the view. Let me just show you that again. And now we can just wait for it. Hello. And there we go. Hello, Alex. Really, really nice. Of course, from the observed, you may go forward and do, let me just go there. So right over here with this mock fetch, you might want to add another service layer, which has your API calls, requests, or whatever. If you are doing it with Firebase, you could just have a service for that also. So that's another thing that's out of scope of IVO. This is a really nice and clean architecture, kind of making MVVM better. So if you do like IVO, go ahead and check it out and use it inside your own apps. And if you do like my teaching style, how I explained IVO, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 1 hour, 60 minutes Zoom session where we can discuss SwiftUI. I can even teach you SwiftUI, or I can just do some bug fixing or whatever you'd like. Go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. And that is IVO, Identifiable View Observed, a really, really simple design pattern for SwiftUI. Now, if you do like my teaching style, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And while you are at it, make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out on the channel. New videos like these ones, go ahead and check them out. They are really awesome and they are about Swift and SwiftUI in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.